Hello everyone, welcome back to Lottie's Creations. Today I'm going to show you how I remove the background from a photo using my Photoshop and my quick selection tool. Let's go ahead and get started. In the left hand toolbar of Photoshop, there's a tool called the quick selection. It allows you to quickly make a selection in Photoshop. I'm going to go ahead and select that tool, and if you look in the toolbar, you will see a plus and a minus sign. The plus sign means you're adding to the image. The minus sign, you're taking away from the image. I'm going to go ahead and click on the plus sign, and as you see the screen, my cursor has turned into a circle with a plus sign. What I do now is left click my mouse and drag around the areas of the photo that I want to select. And don't worry if you pick up any outside edges, because we'll later go in and use the minus sign to remove those selections. So as you can see, I'm just simply tracing the inside area of my photo, holding the left side of my mouse. And then now what I want to do is use the minus sign and clean a little closer to the edge of this image. And that's going to take away any unwanted areas. So I'm going to left click my mouse and just hold it as I drag around the outside edge of my image. Okay. And just keep holding the left edge of the mouse. And then I'll go back and get my plus sign and just add any areas that may have gotten taken away and just bring those back into the selection by left clicking the side of my mouse. Okay, and I'm going to back just get the minus sign now, and I'm just going to clean up around the edge of her hair. And any unwanted areas, I'm going to just take those out. Trying to stay as close to the edge as possible. Okay. And I'm going to get my plus sign again. I see I took a piece out of her hair, so I'm just going to bring that back in. And then again, going to get my minus sign and removing any unwanted areas. Okay, so now you see the marching ants are basically around the outside edge of my image. And what I do now is go into my toolbar at the top of the screen and hit refine edge. And what that's gonna do is show you what the image looks like without the background. And if there's any areas that you want to clean up or touch up, you can kind of get an idea of what they're gonna look like here. So I see that I wanna go to her hair and just kind of clean that a little. And then right here next to her thumb, I'm gonna clean that area. So I'm gonna hit cancel on the refine. And I'm gonna get my minus sign. Now you can zoom into your image if you need to by holding the control and holding the plus sign on the keyboard. And it'll get you a little closer to your design so you can see. And again, I'm using my plus sign there. And with the hair, I'm going to use the minus sign to take away some of that area. And I'm going to zoom out by holding control in the minus sign. And I'm going to go back into the toolbar and hit refine edge. Just kind of take a look at my image. You can see the background is completely removed. And what I do now in the refine edge is I go ahead and turn on smart radius. And what that's going to do is kind of smooth out the edge of my image, and I'll just adjust the radius just a little. And you can see that the edges are more refined. Okay, and you just kind of play with it until you get the edges just like you want them. And then I'm going to also adjust the edge by doing another smoothing, kind of smooth it out just a little. And then what I do, I want this on a layer by itself in Photoshop. So I say output to, and there's a drop down. I always do a new layer with a mask. And that way I can take this image and place it on a chip bag, place it on any other area, and put whatever background behind it. So I'm going to say new layer with layer mask and hit OK. And what you should see is your background now becomes transparent. And what I do, let's say I'm going to put this on a chip bag, I will use my move tool in the toolbar, grab my image, and notice there's no background attached to it, and I'm going to drag it over to a chip bag design that I already have open. So I want this image to be inside of this box. So what I'll do is drag and drop that image. Now it may come in large and you can always adjust it. So here's my image, and what I want to do is come into my layers panel, right click on the image that I just brought in and say create a clipping mask. And what that's going to do is fit that image inside of that box, and no matter when and how I drag this, the image will never come outside of that box. And that's just a shape by using my shape tool. I just made a basic rectangle, put the image on top of that. And then what I'm going to do is go ahead and transform that image by holding Control T as in Tom, and then adjusting my edges. And remember, the little girl was sitting on some steps, so you wouldn't even be able to tell what she was sitting on. So what I do is just kind of bring her there and press enter. And now the background is removed. She sits inside of the box and the image is very clean along the edges. Okay, so that is how I remove the background from any image using the quick selection tool and then dragging that image to whatever item I want to output it on. And then what I would do with this image is save it. I would do a file save as, and I will save it as a PSD in case I need to come back in and edit the actual Photoshop file. And then I would also save it as a PNG, and that way the background is going to stay transparent no matter what I put this image on. So I file save as, and I change it from Photoshop to PNG, and I hit save, and I hit OK. If you have any questions regarding the quick selection tool and how I remove the background, please add that in the comment section, and I will answer those questions accordingly. Also, if there's any tutorials that you all would like for me to create in the future, please go ahead and add those comments as well so that I can work on those tutorials. If you haven't subscribed to my page, please go ahead and hit the subscribe button. And as always, thanks for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you.